Nitaye Gaur Sitanat Premanande. Nitaye Gaur Premanande. Hari Hari
Mahaprabhu called the deity worshipped by Vishnu Priya. Actually, Mahaprabhu's second wife belonged from this village. So when Mahaprabhu departed from this planet, so that when Mahaprabhu left the house to take sannyas, that time Mother Vishnu Priya was completely devastated. Then to console her, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in her dream. And in the dream she was consoled that the neem tree, he was born that with that from the branch of the tree. Vishnu Priya Devi should carve a deity by the help of Bansi Vadan Thakur, and she could worship in place of her husband. So this is how Mahaprabhu actually purposely he manifested in the deity form to take service from his wife Vishnu Priya. So even so, Mahaprabhu, when he departed, still Vishnu Priya Devi was continuing the worshipping around for 75 years. At the end, Vishnu Priya Devi, she entered in that deity. As we hear, like Mirabai, she entered in Dwarka, this deity in Dwarka. In this way, Vishnu Priya Devi entered in that deity. So that deity is called the combined deity of Vishnu Priya and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So sometimes the local people, they say Vishnu Priya temple means Vishnu Priya is called worshipable deity, or also like Vishnu Priya is there in that deity form. So throughout the year, they dress the deity in Vishnu Priya forms at least 5 days, called Radhashtami day, Vishnu Priya's appearance day, and 3 days of swing festival. And whenever someone sponsors a sari, they dress Mahaprabhu in saris, and those days when Mahaprabhu actually wears sari, those days Mahaprabhu looks exactly like Vishnu Priya. So now we are going to visit that place, and after that we'll, on the way we are thinking, because the devotees, they got scattered, so not sure if we find, we are thinking to have interviews with some Malaysian devotees and some other devotees.
Going to Vishnu Priya temple inside me.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, but thank you for being very good.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Tagalog
ko
So this is Dhameshwar Mahaprabhu, the deity that Mother Vishnupriya is to worship. So you can notice that on the in between the lips of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there is a nose ring. While Mother Vishnupriya Devi entered in that deity, then her nose ring stuck on Mahaprabhu's nose. So to remind us, still they put a nose ring on Mahaprabhu's nose. And as I was saying, that throughout a year, they dress Mahaprabhu at least in 5 days in sari. So those days Mahaprabhu look exactly like Vishnupriya. That means this deity is the combined form of Vishnupriya and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Vishnupriya Devi worshipped this deity for a long time, at least around 75 years. So you can have nice darshan of the deity, that as he appeared in the dream of Vishnupriya, like he was speaking to his wife Vishnupriya in the dream.
Parikrama kar dure aji.
Kisu deshe chole gis, baki kisu nas. Yon adha gati, adha chole gis, adha nas.
Kato rok aji, yon parikrama?
Tota parasha.
Ere international?
Kalka ishe sa nati.
Kalka ishe sa nati.
Kalka ishe sa nati.
उदकाचरण
तो हो गया दर्शन करने के लिए
पूरी बोल सकते
हैं जी जय राम जी
की मूविंग बाबूजी की मूविंग हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा
Here we have Kavichandra, His Holiness Kavichandra Maharaj. He has dedicated his life for Shantipur Festival. Every morning you can hear his voice for Shantipur Festival. He is inviting all of you to attend in Shantipur Festival, where Mahaprabhu made a prediction that anyone who gets prasadam, who takes prasadam at Shantipur, will get love of Krishna. On that day, especially the day called Madhavendra Puri's disappearance day. So we have Maharaj with us, so please.
What do you want to hear?
About this place.
This place? This is called Dhameshwar Mahaprabhu. It's said to be the deity here is very big. It's said that Vishnupriya, the wife of Lord Chaitanya, after he left, she was only 16 years old. They were married a short time. And she was a completely dedicated wife. So she became very despondent and was going to commit suicide. So Lord Chaitanya came to her, like a dream or whatever, and he told her, he showed a deity, and I've heard different stories, but anyway, he said, you can worship the deity. One story says that Ishan, the servant, the house servant of Sachimata. He carved this deity from one Nim tree.
Bumsi Badan Thakur.
Nim?
Bumsi Badan Thakur.
No, Ishan. Ishan was at that time. And so later she lived 80 years. He was old at the time, but when she was 16. So after she left, this other Babaji, Bumsi Badan, he brought it over here, and this deity is here. They also have Lord Chaitanya's Paduka. That's why it's called Dameshwar, Lord of the Dham, Mahaprabhu. She chanted every day, all day. And for every round, she'd take one grain of rice. And then however many rounds she chanted, she'd cook that much rice. So even if she chanted 200 rounds, you know, it's not very much rice, right? 200 grains of rice.
Maharaj, each Mahamantra, like...
No, then it would be a bag of rice. One round. And if she chanted all day. So every round is 108. 16 rounds is 1,700. If she had 64 rounds, you got 4,000. No, 8,000. That's a good lot of rice. Anyway, she didn't eat very much. She just did that her whole life until she was 96 years old.
Thank you.
So that's what this temple is. It's been here a long time.
Any special experience, Maharaj, that you have experienced in Parikrama you would like to share with all of us?
No, just realize the value of all devotees. There's so many devotees and how they really like to hear about Krishna. And they're really trying to make advancement. And we all have to help each other. If we want to get to Krishna, we have to go together. Right? So it's a little bit troublesome to have so many devotees. And it's so pleasing to Prabhupada to see so many devotees trying so hard to get to Krishna, right? So that's what the best part of it is. Besides, we get the mercy of the Dham by being right in the Dham, sleeping in the Dham, walking in the Dham. All right?
Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Still, you never turned it off?
Thank you. To be online, so maybe you are wondering that so many devotees from all over the world, they are in Mayapur. They maybe in the whole life they never actually walked barefooted and in the called strong sunshine, still they are making it. So maybe you are wondering that what is the reason that you are taking so much austerity. So it is said in many places in Ananta Samhita that Krishna, suppose there is a pastime.
Audio asana.
What? Bolan.
So, the one pastime took place in Goloka Vrindavan when Radharani created the Navadvip Dham for the pleasure of Krishna. So that time Krishna appeared in front of Radharani, and just before Krishna and Radharani, they became one, like in the combined form. Before that, the last sloka Krishna told to Radharani, in glorification of Navadvip Dham, it is said that Sakrit Gamana Matrena Sarva Tirtha Phala Pradam Abayah Priti Jananim Bhaktim Chalavit Drutam. That means, anyone who comes once, who enters once in Navadvip Dham, gets the benefit of visiting all the holy places in this world. Not only that, the topmost process to make Krishna happy is to offer him the unalloyed love. So that love that person gets easily when he enters in Navadvip Dham. So it is so easy. So on top of that, when someone is coming in Navadvip Dham, visiting, call in 9 days or in 7 days, all islands. So what will be the benefit? Lord Shiva says that he cannot even calculate the benefit of doing the whole Parikrama in Navadvip Dham. So behind that, actually, very fortunately, someone can come here in Navadvip Dham to do this. And many of them, I have been doing this Parikrama from last quite few years. I have seen purposely, though they can afford, like they can come by rickshaw they are very well to do, but still they go on barefoot parikrama without any like shoes, without any umbrella. This is how even they stay, you know, at the end of the destination of the day, they stay the night there, again they join in the next morning. This is how they want to utilize their called human life, dedicating their life for in called Mahaprabhu's service and in other services. So during the day actually we visited many other places that we could not actually update to you. Suppose yesterday when we were passing by the place called Guradaha, so from there around say 100 meters on the left side, we missed a place called Saptarshi Tila, the mounds or the hillocks of the seven sages, the seven sons of Lord Brahma. So that was there, we did not go there or we did not even any, you know, talk about that place. Then there was place Guradaha, we stayed the night there, and then today the first place was Hamsabahan Shiva. Mahaprabhu's associate called Lochandas Thakur actually described that pastime in Chaitanya Mangal. It is very like long pastime. It is said that in the beginning of Kali Yuga, people they became so sinful. While Narada Muni was visiting different holy places and other places in India, so he found people are completely engrossed in sinful activities. So Narada Muni could not find any other way to deliver them, to, you know, save them from hellish suffering. So that time he went to Dwaraka, in the spiritual planet called Dwaraka, while Krishna was talking to Rukmini Devi. And that time Krishna was already deciding with Mother Rukmini that very soon he was going to appear in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And while he was talking about Mahaprabhu's incarnation with Mother Rukmini, and at that moment Narada Muni entered in Dwaraka. So then Krishna got like two audiences, you know, to speak about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's incarnation. So then especially Krishna leaves instruction with Narada Muni that Narada Muni should pass the message to all other saints and sages in this world so that they should prepare to welcome Chaitanya Mahaprabhu on this earth planet. So after getting that instruction from Krishna, Narada Muni, all the way he came to Namisharanya. So when he came to Namisharanya, he met their Uddhava. Actually Krishna left Uddhava and he took all other Dwarka Vasis, Yadavas, with him back to Dwarka planet. So Uddhava was there at Namisharanya. So Narada Muni speaks about Krishna's incarnation in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So when Uddhava came to know, I think he passed the message to other sages in Namisharanya. And after that, Narada Muni goes to Kailas to pass the message to his elder brother Shiva. And when Shiva came to know, that time Shiva was, as actually from last many days, 3 days, you have been hearing the glories of Navadvip Dham. Most of them are from Lord Shiva because he is glorifying Navadvip Dham, which is like told by Lord Vishnu to Ananta Sesh. So Lord Shiva, when he came to know that the 88,000 sages, they are going to Navadvip Dham to glorify Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So from there, when Shiva came to know that, okay, they are going to perform Gaura Bhagavat Katha or Gaura Katha, then Lord Shiva started, you know, sitting on his carrier called bull. While he started for Navadvip Dham, he found his bull was so slow. Then he thought if he would, you know, come by his career, he would end up on the halfway, and by that time the 88,000 sages, they would finish the pastime. So then immediately he went on the top of the, I think, there on Satyaloka, where he borrowed the swan of Lord Brahma, the carrier of Lord Brahma called Swan. So Lord Shiva was not used to, you know, being on the carrier of Lord Brahma. So as he sat on the back of the swan, he flew all the way to the place called Namisharanya. So Lord Shiva could not stay with the speed of the swan. So that's why he leaned on the back of the swan. As you have seen the deity, like the self-manifested deity of Shiva, it's like leaning back on the back of swan. So that is the actual deity, nobody curbed him. In this way, Lord Shiva with his conscience, the swan, he lives there at Naimisharanya in Navadvip Dham with his associates. So that is his deity manifestation. After that, we passed by the place called Brahma Pushkar, which actually is called in this earth planet, that is the only holy place of Lord Brahma, where Brahma is worshipped. So the origin of Brahma Pushkar is in Navadwip Dham, where we visited. It's not properly called manifested yet, but in future we are expecting it will manifest in his original form. So there is also a long pastime how in Satya Yuga there was a Brahman called Dibodas. At his middle age of his life, he decided to visit the holy places. So on his holy places, visiting some holy places, so he decided to come to Pushkara, holy place.
Wow, तुम लोग का live दिखाएगा live दिखा रहा है सब. हाँ इधर आओ सब live दिखा रहा है इधर आओ इधर सब live दिखा रहा है लो book लो एक हाथ में लो सब live.
Sorry, I'm getting.
Line आओ सब घूमो प्रभुजी खींचेगा live दिखा.
So Dibodas, when he came to that place.
Then,
so when he came to that place called Brahma Pushkar, then he had a dream that, my dear Brahman, where you are going? This is Brahma Pushkar. So Dibodas, he stayed there for a long time, but he did not see any lake or Brahma Pushkar. So then he was feeling like, I'm cheated, like, I thought this is like the real holy place. So he thought that time he was old, was not able to walk all the way to Rajasthan, where the Brahma Pushkar, in his eyes, in his mind, he thought Brahma Pushkar is there. So that he was repenting that he wasted his time and he could not visit Brahma Pushkar. Then while he was worried, that time Brahma Pushkar in person, he appeared in front of that Brahmana called Dibodas. And that time personified Brahma Pushkar, he was talking to Dibodas. My dear Brahmana, why you are worried? Me, that I appeared in your dream. So you see behind there is Pushkar Raj. So as Dibodas looked behind, he saw that same lake that you have taken darshan. So that time Dibodas, he was so embarrassed that, for me, such a poor unqualified Brahmana, all the way you have to come for my satisfaction, you have to come from Ajmer to this place. Then personified Brahma Pushkar, he told, no, this is my original place where I reside eternally, but the other Brahma Pushkar, that is not my original. So I did not come from there, I stay here. So for that Brahman Dibodas, personified Brahma Pushkar, he appeared in this form. So this is also a self-manifested lake, actually nobody dug it. A very amazing place. It is said in glorification of that place, that anyone who takes bath at that place, he becomes like completely purified. And all the holy places of this earth planet, they come to take bath in that Brahma Pushkara thrice a day to wash their sins, because they can take sins from their other places, but they have no power to digest those sins. Only Brahma Pushkara here, he can digest. That means he can nullify the sins. So other holy places, they wash their sins taking bath in that Brahma Pushkara. In this way, Lord Shiva says, Lord Shiva says that him, his associates and all other Kailasubhasis, they reside on the banks of Brahma Pushkara. That is, in short, about Brahma Pushkara. Then we passed by Krukshetra, that place, and Panchaveni. So there are many places. I personally would leave a call message with you, that if you have any questions, any comments, you can write to our mayapur.tv. Our call devotees are there who are broadcasting directly, so they can pass the questions to us, and if we know those answers, we will get back to you tomorrow. Thank you. Now you will find out some devotees actually would like to have some interviews with some other devotees, because many devotees, they have taken you know, the call austerity of to go on like Navadwip Mandal Parikrama for 7 days. So you can also hear something, what about our, you know, about their realizations, how they are experiencing practically in Navadwip Dham. So we are going around. If we find some devotees, we'll have interviews with them. Still the devotees are on the way. Actually we came here by cycle rickshaw, so we are little ahead of time. Okay, little update about Panchaveni, where we took breakfast. While Nitananda Prabhu, he came on Parikrama with Jiva Goswami, Advaita Acharya, Srivas Thakur and others. So when they came to that place, like that is the border of Madhyadip, the third island of Navadwip Dham. So when he came to that spot, he was very happy. So standing on that side where we took breakfast, he was explaining the glories of that place. He was saying that when Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu, they were terrorizing the whole planet, say three planets. That time Lord Brahma had no other way. So with his sons and other sages, he left his planet, Satyaloka, and he was looking for such a place where he could perform some sacrifices. So at the end, he came to that spot on the other side of where we took breakfast, on the other side of the river. He came to that place and there he started performing sacrifices. So according to Nitananda Prabhu saying that he performed millions of sacrifices at that place to counteract the terrorism of Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu. Then Nitananda Prabhu goes on that from one of the sacrifices, Lord Varahadev, he appeared from Lord Brahma's sacrificial area and then he took a huge form. Then after that, he goes to the lower planet where Mother Earth was hidden. So Lord Varahadev went there, he lifted Mother Earth planet, established her on her proper place, then he started fighting with Hiranyaksha. So at the end, it is said they had a long fight. At the end, Lord Varaha kills Hiranyaksha there on the other side, which is called the identical Giriraj Govardhan in Navadwip Dham. So on the top of Giriraj Govardhan, Lord Varahadev kills Hiranyaksha. Because of that pastime, that island got name called Kolodip. Kolo means another name of Lord Varahadev. After that, Nitananda Prabhu glorifies that place in that way, that anyone there in water or in air or on the ground who leaves his body in that area goes back to Goloka Vrindavan. And then he glorifies the place that it was already a such a holy place in this universe that in Brahma's eyes he could not see a second place like that place. On top of that, when he performed such sacrifices to bring peace in this universe, then those sacrifices actually made that place so potential, so important, that anyone who leaves his body at that place straight away goes back to Goloka Vrindavan, no matter where he leaves his body, in water, on the ground, or in the air. So this is in short about that place. Nitananda Prabhu said the sloka, according to his sloka, he means that 5 Ganges, they flow together at that place, the confluence of 5 Ganges called Alakananda. He mentioned Alakananda, Mandakini, Bhagavati Ganga, Manasi Ganga and Bhagirathi Ganga. So these 5 Ganges, they met together at that place. In this universe, that is the only place where 5 Ganges who flow in different planets. As per Nitananda Prabhu saying, those all holy places from heavenly planet till Rasatala planet, they all are present in Navadwip Dham. Not only they are present, by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, those holy places, they can give you 10 billion times more result than other places. It is unbelievable, but it is quoted in Sanskrit sloka that yatirtha vartate shriman navadvipi vibhagasa tatirtha mahima tatra sata koti gunam kalo. So 100 crore means 10 billion. So this is how Panchavani is so glorifying place, called so glorified. Before Panchavani, we crossed a place on our right hand side. That time we had a view of a brick factory. Before, it used to be like a nice field, which is called Kurukshetra, the identical Kurukshetra place in Navadvip Dham. So now the local people, they converted it into a like brick factory, unfortunately. So that is also an important place where the demigods, they perform kirtan, they glorify Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Navadvip Dham. And then we came all the way chanting and dancing all the way to the place called Jagannath Das Babaji's place. There we had actually the devotees, they were a bit tired, they got scattered, so it was not properly organized to like have class. So I think some devotees are still at the second place where we visited Dameshwar Mahaprabhu. So a little bit about Jagannath Das Babaji. The Jagannath Das Babaji, he appeared in Bangladesh, then he went to Vrindavan. So he lived long time in Vrindavan. After that, he realized that Vrindavan Dham is very hard to get mercy of Radha Krishna. So there he realizes to come to Navadvip Dham, who is so compassionate, who is so kind, that Navadvip Dham actually ignores called sins or so-called offenses. Anyone who is little serious in Krishna consciousness is like easily they can get love of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So because of that, Jagannath Das Babaji comes to that place, and he was living there. After some time, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur came to know, so he built a little bhajan kutir for him. So he was staying there, he was residing there at that place, at the bank of the Ganga. So during his stay there, he had many pastimes, like the senior Prabhuji was explaining how he used to act with the dhambasis. Like at the bank of the Ganga, there used to be a she-dog who gave birth to puppies. And Jagannath Das Babaji, in his spiritual eyes, he realized those puppies were such elevated souls that whenever Jagannath Das Babaji would take his prasadam, he would sit around with the puppies around his prasadam plate. Though he could see, but his eyelids were so big that they covered his eyes. So he could see, but because of his eyelids, if someone would help him lifting his eyelids, he could see. So whenever he would take prasadam, he would stretch out his hand to reach the puppies. So when they all would be there, then Jagannath Das Babaji would eat from the same plate. While Jagannath Das Babaji, who used to be the topmost called Babaji in those days, when Jagannath Das Babaji was doing that, then actually his servant Bihari Darshi, he found it was a little awkward, like how come such an established Babaji can eat with the puppies. So that time one day he hid the puppies, and that time he served prasadam to Jagannath Das Babaji, to his guru. And Jagannath Das Babaji, when he could not find the puppies, then he said, until you bring the puppies back, I'm not going to take prasadam. So this is how he used to react, or he used to deal with the dhambasis. Now our kirtan party is here. Maybe we'll receive them at the place where our devotees will stay the night, and then again tomorrow. From here, the devotees will go by boat. They will go to Samudra Gaon for the first place for the fourth day of our parikrama. Hare Krishna. Thank you. Here we have actually many times I saw him in Navadvip Mandal Parikrama. So usually as a friend I actually call him as Dummy Prabhu. Actually, his name is Surya Prabhu. So we are inquisitive actually to know, like, you know, he has very difficulty to do it. I mean, do Navadvip Mandala Parikrama. Still, we find him every year on Navadvip Mandala Parikrama. So Prabhuji, actually, what is your personal experience about Navadvip Mandala Parikrama?
Well, my personal experience about Navadvip Mandala Parikrama is amazing. It's a wonderful event where we get purified by visiting various places of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes in the Holy Dham, as well as getting the celebrations of what they did from the present acharyas, from ISKCON, the gurus, and it's very enlivening to see these pastimes which happened 500 over years ago, and how is it changing the world's perspective, the consciousness of the people for a better golden age.
You think all of them, like, you know, even our online devotees who are watching Navadvip Mandala Parikrama, they should also come from your experience, they should also take part in this Parikrama festival, Parikrama event?
Definitely, I would recommend anybody who is wanting to come for this Parikrama, or who is have not been for this Navadvip Mandala Parikrama, to make a one-time life experience coming to Sridhar Mayapur, especially during the Navadvip Mandala Parikrama.
Anything specially you liked in Parikrama, or you did not like any, how do you say? Actually, as per we know, like, we are having nice prasadam, everything is arranged. So what made you so attracted to Navadvip Mandala Parikrama?
I get rejoice and I feel recharged. And it's a wonderful experience when you know who you are, especially that you are not this body, but you are part and parcel of Krishna. You are a spirit soul, and the spirit soul needs love. And you can only get through love through if you know who God is. And it is amazing how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving that love, the love of God, of Krishna, to everyone, immaterial of their qualifications. So that is the main reason I'm coming back every year for this Navadvip Mandala Parikrama, which I get rejoice.
So you have any idea that how many devotees they have joined from Malaysia in this Parikrama?
I don't have any idea, but I've seen quite a number of Malaysian devotees. Perhaps about 60 or 70 Malaysian devotees.
60, 70 devotees from Malaysia.
Right.
As you know, like, we are having six parties. We name them in different called Mahaprabhu's associates' name. Our party officially, it is named as called Gauranga Group. In Namahatta, I mean Bengali groups, we have three Bengali groups. The first Bengali group is known as Nityananda group. The second is called Gadadhar group. And now the third is called Srivash group. So the Russian devotees, they have another Parikrama party. They are known as Advaita group. And the Hindi party, they are known as Srivash group. And Bengali, the third party, they are known as Prabhupada party. And the Russians, they are known as Advaita Acharya's group. So in this way, we have six groups. In 7 days, we have six tents set up. So in every single tent, all the groups, you know, like, they stay a night. So I'm thinking, like, in future, maybe we'll have, you know, many other countries coming. So maybe we'll have more devotees from different countries, especially like Prabhuji is saying, they have around 60 devotees. And in the beginning day, I heard there are around 70 devotees from China. They took part, most of them, on this Parikrama, but some of them, they are staying back in the temple for some other called program. I think they will be joining from 9. So it is nice. Prabhu, you want to leave, like, any person, you want to share your like personal, how do you say, feelings, that is it like, how do you say, is it worth to like invite them for this Parikrama? Like, I mean, they should come in more numbers to get the benefit of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Yes. So my personal feeling is that everybody should participate in this Navadvip Mandal Parikrama at least once in their lifetime, and get rejoiced, get recharged, and come again and enjoy the mood of this beautiful holy dham. You know, what is true enjoyment? Enjoyment means hearing the pastimes of the Lord, taking prasad in the association of devotees,
yes,
having kirtan in the association of devotees, respecting one another, and seeing how the mercy is flowing from the spiritual world. It's a very, very happy moment to be here in Navadvip Mandal Parikrama, and I would like to actually personally invite everybody here to take part in this annual Navadvip Mandal Parikrama.
Thank you, Prabhu,
thank
for
you.
Your wonderful experience.
Hare Krishna.
Maybe we will see you again in next year.
Perhaps, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna.
Surya Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Okay, so my name is Rukmini Nardas. We have, you know, like viewers, they are called doing mental parikramas of Navadvip. They will also get the, almost the same benefit if they are sincere on this. It is said in Navadvip Dham, glories of Navadvip Dham, really have, I'm sorry to like, when I speak before, maybe I'm not qualified, that, yeah, anyone, if he is the most fallen person in the society, if he remembers once the Navadvip, that four letters, in Sanskrit, it comes like, say, four letters composed, you know, it makes the Navadvip word. So anyone who chants that word or just thinks, immediately he becomes so purified that his name immediately goes on the top of the pious credit list, just for remembering once. So those who are like mentally thinking or watching, like devotees, they are walking barefooted, listening the glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the pastimes, and like they are having all the transcendental dust of Navadvip Dham, associating devotees, taking Gauranga Prasadam. In this way, then they are aware of this or not, certainly they will get some result. Maybe like with our tiny brain, it is hardly possible to calculate all these things. Like if we think a rat is so small, like a mouse, how come a rat can carry such a big personality called Ganesh?
Yes.
But Ganesh's carrier is the mouse. It's very unbelievable. In this way, with our brain, maybe we cannot understand seeing the external form of Navadvip Dham, but actually we get so much benefit. Vadibhai Prabhu, would you like to be introduced with our viewers?
Yes, ma'am. Myself is Keshav Murari Das. I'm from Delhi, Punjab Vibhag. I live in Punjab Vibhag, and I'm temple president for Rohini project.
Oh, thank you, Prabhu.
So, new temple coming up in Rohini. It's going to be a huge, big temple. It will be a fourth temple, in big temple in Rohini. Earlier there was a Delhi temple, Radha Parasarthi, and one more temple in Punjab Vibhag. It was medium temple. And one more temple is coming up in Dwarka, and fourth one is Rohini one. So it is under construction right now, and the devotees are struggling. They are praying to the Lord and trying their best to make this temple. And I got the time to make myself energetic, so I came here, Navadvip Parikrama.
So is this your first time?
No, Prabhuji. First time I came on 2004 actually.
Okay.
And three, 4 more years I was continued this parikrama. And last three, four years I was not continued because of some more engagement in management and other programs. So this time I thought I should start it again, because coming here is a different experience, out of the world experience. Whatever, like we charge our mobile time to time, so similarly, a devotee who is preaching, who is managing, he needs some charging also. So this place, the Navadwip, surcharges the devotees with the divine powers. By this power, this energy, when he goes back to his working area, he feels this power. He feels this energy, and if he is a preacher, then he feels this energy in preaching. If he is a book distributor, he feels this energy in book distribution. And if he is a manager, he will do lots of good things. So I am happy to be here.
You must have done Vrindavan Mandal Parikrama in Vrindavan.
Actually, we are in Delhi, and like Calcutta has very near this Mayapur Dham. And from Delhi, very near is Vrindavan Dham. But unfortunately, for myself, I never done Churasi course program so far. I'm very eager to do this, but because it takes whole 1 month, so this is a problem for me. But here, in Navadwip, it takes only 7 days, so for us it is, you know.
Also, I heard that even like children, you must have seen little, you know, children, they are walking without shoes, and they look so beautiful, carrying their, like, you know, small big bags, chanting. And also some aged Matajis, Prabhus, sometimes they cannot, they take rickshaw, but still whenever they can, they try to walk. One family from Australia, Melbourne, that Mataji, she has her knee problem, but still she is managing. So I get inspiration from those devotees. So I heard that in Vrindavan you have to walk for whole month, which is longer walk every day. I think the longest walk is around 35 kilometers.
One day.
Yeah, one day.
Yes.
And in Navadwip Dham it is so easy. Though there is no, practically there is no difference in Navadwip Dham and in Vrindavan Dham, but still Navadwip is so merciful. Compared to, like, if we think we are beggars, like we have no love of Krishna, that's why we are beggar of love. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, he prayed, na dhanam na janam na kavitam na sundarim kamaye imama janmani janmani sarva bhavatad bhavatad bhakti rahai to kitvai. That means he wants bhakti, the love of Krishna. In this way, we all are actually lacking this same thing. Mahaprabhu taking the position of a devotee, he prayed the same thing. In this way, Mahaprabhu's dham is induced, full of actually Krishna prema. So that's why most of the devotees, actually many of them I've seen before doing parikrama, almost every year they keep doing. So it is very comfortable, actually, from my personal experience I can say. Just 7 days, everything is like organized, so they can get so much benefit. So it is nice, Prabhu, that from Delhi you can hear and you are staying with us, giving us association for 7 days. And you stay here in night, Prabhu, or you
yes,
go
yes.
back to
work? Actually, whenever I came here to attend Parikram, I tried my level best to be here only so that I can spend whole night here. I saw there are so many devotees from the many countries. They are taking this austerity with their heart. They are barefoot, they are walking, and they have seen good opulence in their country. They were very, you know, but still they are here in Navadwip, they are barefoot, they are walking, and they are staying with us in the night. They are using the same toilets, and there is a, you know, cold in night sometimes.
So mosquitoes.
Yes, mosquitoes are there.
Bed.
Yes. So many difficulties they are facing, but still, what I have seen, whoever is doing this austerities, you know, Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, I love my devotees who are more detached, vairagya pradhan. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu loves their devotee who is more in austerity, in Krishna consciousness. Chaitanya, I was also barefoot right now. So I was walking. So I was just thinking that Krishna is very merciful. Why so? Because we may have done so many sinful activities in our past life. But because Krishna is so powerful, so merciful, when we are walking on the road and there's so many, you know, stones and they are pricking us. But I was thinking, this all pigment, all the problems we are facing here, it is just re-educating, you know, it's our karmas, our sinful activities are going to re-educate. So I'm very happy to, you know, thinking about, you know, thinking like this. So I request to each and everyone who is watching this, if they have not done so far, they must come. If they have done but this time they couldn't come, they should watch the television, Mayapur TV, and they should see, they should be with us whole day, and they see how we are going to the each and every temple, how devotees are dancing. Yesterday I was not feeling okay, I'm not feeling good actually, I was sick. So still, they gave me opportunity to sing. So I was singing, my throat was little, but still I was singing. I was thinking that Lord Chaitanya, he wants me to sing. So I was singing, and earlier, if I was walking, so I was very cautious, you know, when I was walking. My speed was 10, but when I was singing, so I was not sitting down, and I was just running with the mic. So
your consciousness was completely engrossed by kirtan.
Yes, yes. So it is really very good to have such a nice, beautiful, and pure devotee here, the association of. And it is really very, very difficult to have this type of association. Even demigods, it is said, you know, they are hankering for this type of association. And if they, I read somewhere in Srimad Bhagavatam, devotees of the Lord, demigods, they pray to the Lord of Krishna.
In the fifth canto,
that please, if you want us to be a, in giving us a new birth, so please give us it in India, Bharat Bhumi. So that, because we, with the opulence, we are engaging in our services, we forget your Charan Kamal, you know, your lotus feet. So here we are, you know, having such a nice association of Maharaj. All Maharajas with us, they are, you know, giving such a nice lectures. And whenever we are stopped somewhere, they give nice talk about that particular place, the Leela, and some philosophical more inputs they give us. And more thing is, when in the evening we sit together, Maharaj, you know, people send so many questions to them. And these questions are very, very precious questions actually. Because sometimes we have not time to give, ask questions also. Because devotees from all over the world, they write some questions and they give to the Maharaj. And Maharaj very nicely, very intelligently, very shastrically, he's answering all the doubts and questions of the devotee. So devotees are getting 100% relishment from here, by just coming here, by chanting, sankirtan, and they are distributing books also, and they are doing austerity, and devotees are, you know, from all over the world, they are enjoying this trip. So I request each and everybody, please come here, be with us. Everywhere try to come. I heard that when I for 7 years before I was here. So at that time only two parties were there. One is Bengali party and second one was international party. Now I have heard that there are 6 parties and more than 10,000 devotees are on Parikrama. This is amazing. And I'm amazed to hear this. So slowly, devotees of the world, they are becoming more attracted by Navadwip Dham. So this is only by the mercy of Krishna and Mahaprabhu. He's distributing his love very freely, very easily. And somehow or other, each and every, the meat eaters, the smokers, the, you know, the people who are sinners, they are somehow or other get attracted by the devotees, the philosophies, the kirtan, the books, and they are coming here. It was Navadwip Mayapur Dham. Even in India, no, devotees are coming from all over the world to be here to attend this parikram. In India, you know, people don't know. They know much. Yes, they don't even know where is Navadwip, where is Mayapur. Even in Calcutta, people, when I was coming here by the train, one lady I met, she said, "Where are you going?" So I said, "I'm going to Mayapur." She never heard Mayapur. She was never been here. So it means you need to preach more. There are so many people are here and there, those who are not aware of this spiritual dham. So everyone should, you know, preach also about this dham.
Wonderful experience, Prabhu. Thank you for sharing your experience.
Thank you very much for calling me here. Thank you very much. Everyone, Hare Krishna, please do come. Thank you very much. Bye bye. It's time to take prasad also. Please be with us. We'll tell you what we are eating. Nice prasadam, Prabhu. You cannot find it in your home. Be with us and take rasgulla also. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, Badi bhai, there are few types of dambasis. It is called, who usually takes birth in the holy dham, they are dambasis. Then some of them, they purposely knowingly, they live in the dham. I mean, to get the benefit of the dham, they take shelter in the dham. So they are another kind of dambasis. Some of them, they come for a short time, like this is Parikrama time. So they are, at least they are staying for 7 days. So they are also one kind of dambasis. And then there are, they are called the fourth category is false, that who are mentally living in Navadvip dham. So at least if you are for certain hours, certain time, you are mentally in Navadvip dham. So you are also living in Navadvip dham. You are getting, you know, some benefit of Navadvip dham. So, time to time, we will try to update you. Again, I will try to remind you that if we have any questions, any comments, or any, how do you say, any doubts, you can ask online, you can, you know, ask your questions, then we will try to update it. If we know the answer, we will get back to you. So if you write it today, maybe tomorrow we can update to it. Thank you. Hare Krishna.